Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 6-142 that is taken from chapter number 6, Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. And the topic is curved beam. So statement is, if the maximum bending stress at section AA is not allowed to exceed 150 MPa, determine the maximum allowable force that can be applied to the end of the beam. So you can see this is a curved beam, clear, and it is given that allowable stress should not exceed 150 MPa at section AA, clear, and we have to find the largest load P that can be applied to this curved beam. So let's start with the solution. As we know that the formula that are used in curved beam is this one. This is for stress. This is E, which is R dash minus R1, R capital R. So R dash is distance from the center of curvature till the centroid of this section. Clear, this will be R dash, and R capital R is distance from this center of curvature till the neutral axis, because in curved beam, neutral axis and centroidal axis do not pass each other. So we'll find this term as well, and this R, capital R, can be obtained by using this formula. So we'll see them in a while. So first step is that if you cut this beam, curved beam, at section AA, so I have already drawn the free body diagram over here, FBD. So you will have a shear force will be, which will be acting upwards. So this will be V, which is VA dash A, and you will be having a moment which is equal to MAA. So we'll find this MAA by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moment about neutral axis must be equal to zero, taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about this neutral axis, the first moment will be this P into perpendicular distance is this 0.6 meter, and it is producing counterclockwise moment, so it will be positive. And at this, we have a moment MAA which is clockwise, and their sum must be equal to zero. So I will write P into 0.6 minus MAA is equal to zero. So it means that MAA will be equal to 0.6 times P. We do not know P, so this will be MAA, which will be 0.6 P. Okay, now you can see this moment, and due to this force, there will be a moment will causing bending moment in this curved portion. So as a result, this moment is this, and this moment is this. So it will straighten up this beam, curved beam, over here. So this top portion will be in tension, clear, and this bottom portion will be in compression. So we have to find the maximum load. So for that, we will find maximum bending stress at this top as well as maximum stress at the bottom. This is for top and this is for bottom, and from this we will find the P value. Okay, now we have this moment. So what we will do is that we will find this term, which is R dash. So R dash is distance from center of curvature till the centroid of this section. So this is the section, you can see section AA. So this is the center of curvature. So if I draw a horizontal line from center of curvature, so we will find this R dash. Now you can see this T section will be divided into two portions. This will be first portion and this one will be second one. Okay, so there are two rectangles. So we know that we have, for this two rectangles, we have centroid formula will be equal to sum of y dash bar into a divided by sum of area. Now we have two sections, so y1 dash into a1 plus y2 dash into a2 divided by a1 plus a2. We will find this A1. So A1, you can see this total width is 75 millimeter. 25, 25, 25. So 75 millimeter is 0.075 multiplied by this thickness is 20 millimeter, which is 0.02, and the unit will be square meter. Now A2 will be how much? So you can see the height is 50. So 0.050 into thickness is 25 millimeter, which is 0.025, and the unit will be square. Now what is y1 dash? So y1 dash is distance from this center of curvature till the mid of this section. This is your y1 dash. So this is y1 dash, and y1 dash, you can see distance from center of curvature till point A is 300. Radius is given, so half of 20 is 10. So 300 plus 10 is 310. So 310 will be equal to 0.310 meter. And y2 dash is distance from center of curvature till the center of second section. So this is y2 dash. And this y2 dash will be equal to, let me show you, 300 plus this 20 and half of 50, which is 25. So 320 plus 25 is 345 millimeter. So 345 is actually 0.345 meter. Now you have all this value, just plug it in this formula. So r dash will be equal to y1, which is 0.310 multiplied by area is 0.075 multiplied by 0.02 plus y2 dash is 0.345 multiplied by area, which is 0.05 multiplied by 0.025 divided by sum of area A1 and A2. So A1 is 0.075 multiplied by 0.02 plus 0.050 multiplied by 0.025. Okay. So when you calculate it, you will get r dash will be equal to 0.325909 meter. So let me draw it. So it is distance from neutral axis till the centroid of this section. Let centroid is this C point, clear? So it will be the distance from center of curvature till this point. So this is r dash. Okay, r dash, and that comes out to be 0.325909 meter. Now what we will do is that we will find the second term, that is capital R. So capital R is distance from center of curvature till the point where neutral axis lie, and you can see this R can be obtained by using this formula, which is equal to A divided by integral of dA over R over the area A. What is A? So A is equal to total area of cross sections, which is equal to A1 plus A2. So when you add A1 plus A2, so A1 is 0.02 multiplied by 0.05 plus A2 is 0.05 multiplied by 0.025. So when you add them, you will get this area, and this area comes out to be 2.75 into 10 raised to the power minus 3 square meter. We have found out this. Now we'll find this term, integral of dA over R for the entire area. So that can be obtained by using this table 6.6-1. So where you can see in one column shapes are given, and in other column the formula for this is given. Since we have rectangle shape, there are two rectangles. Remember that this line is the line that is passing through center of curvature. So from center of curvature, the first end of this rectangle is at a distance of R1, and second end is at a distance of R2, and the width of rectangle is B. So we will start for first one. So you can see this is first one. So this center of curvature till the start of first rectangle, this is the first rectangle, this R1 will be equal to 300 millimeter, which is 0.300, and R2 will be this one, which is equal to 0.320 meter, and width is this one, which is 75 millimeter. So I will write down these all values. So you can see the formula for this is B. So B for the first rectangle was 0.075 ln of R2. R2 was 0.320 divided by 0.30. Now for the second rectangle, you can see this is the second rectangle. This is second rectangle. One edge of this from the centroid is this, which is 0.320, and that will R1 for the second rectangle, and R2 is this one, which is total height from the center of curvature, which is 0.345 0.37. Let me show you 0.37. You can see this distance is 300, this is 20, and this is 50. So 370. So R2 is 0.37, and breadth is 25 millimeter for the section 2. Okay. So write down its formula as well. So I will write B is 0.075 and multiply by ln of R2 was 0.370 divided by 0.320. Okay. Now when you solve this integral of dA over R for the entire area comes out to be 8.46994 into 10 raised to power minus 3 meter. I will also represent this R. So R is distance from neutral axis till the point where its neutral axis lie. You can see this is its neutral axis. And this capital R is less than this R. This is capital R, which is 0.324678 meter. In curved beam, the neutral axis and centroidal axis do not pass. So you can see the difference over here. Now we have this. So you can just put in formula number 3, which is E is equal to R dash minus R. So R dash is 0.325909. You can see this one minus this capital R. We do not find R. So A is this one, 2.75 into 10 to the power minus 3, and integral term is this, divided by 8.46994 into 10 to the power minus 3. So R will be equal to 0.324678 meter. Okay. Now just put it in here, 0.24678. So you will get E is equal to 1.2314 into 10 raised to power minus 3, and unit will be meter. These are very lengthy problems, so you have to be very careful. You should not have any mistake. Now you have all this value, you can just use this formula. Sigma is equal to, let me write, sigma is equal to M into capital R minus small r divided by AE into R. Now what is R? R is distance from center of curvature to the point where you find the stress. So we are interested to find out the maximum stress. So that will be in outer region and this lower region, top region and bottom region. So it means point A and C are our main focus. So point A, R will be equal to RA, that will be equal to 300 millimeter, which is 0.3 meter. And for C, R will be equal to 0.37 meter. Okay. So first we will find for point A. So for point A, R is equal to RA, which is equal to 0.3 meter. And we have maximum, we know that allowable stress is equal to maximum moment into R minus RA divided by area into E into RA. We have maximum allowable stress is 150 megapascal. So what we will do is that point A is in tension. I will write point A is in tension. I have already told you about this. So this allowable stress will be positive. So 150 megapascal, so 150 into 10 raised to power 6 is equal to moment. Moment is 0.6 times P, and capital R is 0.32467 minus RA 0.3 divided by area, which is 2.75 into 10 raised to power minus 3 multiplied by E is 1.2314 into 10 raised to power minus 3 and RA 0.3. So from here, you can calculate this P will be equal to 150 multiplied by 10 raised to power 6 multiplied by 2.75 into 10 raised to power minus 3 multiplied by 1.2314 into 10 raised to power minus 3 into 0.3 divided by 0.6 multiplied by 0.32467 minus 0.3. So when you solve this, you will get P will be equal to 10.292.09, or that will be equal to 10.29 or 10 raised to power 3 kilo Newton. Now this is the maximum load P that can be applied at due to the maximum moment at point A. For point C, I will write for point C, which is in compression, we have RC is equal to 0.370 meter. So just put it in this formula. Allowable stress is equal to M into R minus RC divided by A in E into RC. So moment will be equal to allowable stress multiplied by area multiplied by E multiplied by RC divided by R minus RC. Plug in the all the values. So moment will be equal to allowable stress is, this is in compression, so it will be minus 150 into 10 raised to power 6 into A is 2.75 into 10 raised to power minus 3, E is 1.231 into 10 raised to power minus 3 multiply by this RC, which is 0.370, divided by this capital R is 0.32467 minus 0.370, and that is equal to moment. So moment is equal to 0.6 times P. I will replace this moment with 0.6 times P. Clear? So that we should have, as we have less spacing, so 0.6 times P. If you divide 0.6 on both sides, so you will get P will be equal to, and solve for P, so you will get P will be equal to 6911.55 Newton, or that will be equal to 6.91 kilo Newton. So this is the value of, this is the value of load for the maximum stress at point C. Now you have two value, one is this one and another one is this one. So you have always, you have to choose load that will be lesser. So 6.91 kilonewton is the amount of load that can be applied to the point E. This is 6.91 kilonewton, which is the answer of our this question. Why we are choosing the smallest load? Because you can see this is satisfying this condition. So when you put this load, P is equal to 10 point in this equation. Clear? In this equation. So it will exceed the allowable stress, which will cause failure. So we will choose this smaller load, which is 6.91, that will satisfy the condition. And that was all about this problem 6-42. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.